What's up guys, it's your boy Dick Dash and I'm back for another video. And in this video, we're going to be looking at the wonderful, the fantastic Gran Turismo Beta. Gran Turismo 7 Beta. I mean, I've really been looking forward to this game. I've been playing Gran Turismo since Gran Turismo 2, you know? So, it's just really a pleasure to, and I'm really blessed to be able to have access to this beta on my PS4. I waited a long time for this. I can't wait for the game to come out. So yeah, basically just want to show you, give you a quick playthrough of this beta, how it works, you know, kind of like give you an idea of how it handles in terms of the handling of the cars, whether it feels realistic or not, whether it's an improvement on Gran Turismo 6. Basically, you're going to play this game, you're going to watch, and I'll just give you my thoughts as I am driving through it. So I'm just using the PS4 controller. I don't have a dedicated steering wheel at the moment, but I'll work on that and have a whole rig by the time this joke comes up. I've already played this game yesterday, actually got it, downloaded it yesterday. So just a quick playthrough of what I've kind of discovered and what I've done so far. So I'm gonna try not to make this too long. So basically it's got a traditional kind of home menu, but it's been reimagined and looks a lot better than the previous incarnation, which was Gran Turismo 6. It's clearer, it makes more sense, and you've got a campaign mode, which I can't wait to try. Sport mode, online mode, arcade, VR tour. I can't wait to try that shit out. Brand Central, not sure what that's about, I guess that's about the cars. Scrapes, I have no idea what that could be about. But and you've got daily races, which is part of the beta. But fortunately, they only work and happen at specific times, test hours. So I've not had an online race. I'm looking forward to it. There's a date, there's a calendar, so I guess that's where they're gonna be announcing like race events or whatnot. Menu guide, you got online menu, which is you can go through that or not. But gives you a breakdown of, you know, the controls, different control layouts, the home screen layout. It's quite in depth. So I will read this one day, or not. You've got the options, so you've got the opening movie, you can decide whether it starts up or not. Video output, which is very interesting, because it allows you to enable HDR. I've just got the normal PS4, I haven't got the Pro. But HDR on the Pro, so HDR on the normal PS4, fantastic. I've got HDR TV, so I'm definitely making full use of it. Unfortunately, it's not in 4K, but you know, hopefully by the time it's released on the PS4 Pro, I'm gonna take advantage of the 4K capabilities. But then again, if it does, it'll probably only run in 30 frames per second, whereas I do believe that this demo runs 1080p HDR at 60 frames per second, which is astonishing. So I'd rather take 60 frames per second at 1080p rather than 4K at 30 frames per second, because it's all about smoothness and fluidity, especially in driving games. But so yes, here's the controllers. You can change the vibration settings. You can change your buttons for the racing. I've got some kind of jacked up button for the button arrangement at the moment. I need to work on that. And you can obviously set up your various steering wheels, which I need to invest in when this game is released. Not right now, but when it's released. Here's the garage. So here's my car list. So at the moment I have a M6 GT3. It feels absolutely amazing. Got the Corvette. The TT was the very first car that was given to me in the game. Every day you have to do a certain amount of miles and they'll throw you a free car. So I'm definitely gonna get these miles up and I'll show you what I get today. And the GTR3 spec car is just, it's just absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. I'll show you in a second. Obviously you've got your car settings, you can change things up, power ratios, weight ratios, racing tires, the ride height you can adjust, spring rate, stabilizers, etc., camber angle, downforce, you know, LSD, that's a differential gear, change the settings on that, Obviously, the transmission setting is fully adjustable because this is the race spec car, therefore has fully adjustable metrics. And obviously shows you the power, max torque, the weight, drivetrain, which is front engine rear wheel drive because it's an M6 race car. But yeah, let me try and get these miles up. Just have to show the free car that I get today, which will be surprising me because I'm not actually, I have no idea what it could be. So today, it's the race. The entry period starts at 7:45 UK time. It's a very short period. So I've got quite a few hours to wait until I can actually do this, but until then, that's the online race that is. Until then, I can enter the qualifying time trial in this car. And I mean, playing this game, the car feels very realistic. You can feel the understeer, oversteer, you can feel the tires sliding. Almost feels like you can feel the tires sliding on the tarmac. Feel the weight difference, you can feel kind of like the weight transfer as you're accelerating, decelerating. It has a very realistic feel. I mean, GT6 felt very realistic, but this takes it up a notch, which makes it very difficult to play if you're driving one of the higher power cars like this. This is essentially a race car, so it's very grippy. And one of the more interesting things that I've discovered is, well, I found out, is that as you're increasing your speed, the dynamics, the aerodynamics come into play. So you feel like you're more stuck to the ground as you're moving, as you're driving faster. And you didn't really have that sensation in Gran Turismo 6. In this game, you can definitely feel the aerodynamics in play. So the wings, the front wings, the rear wing, you can definitely feel the downforce as you're hitting like 100 miles an hour. It feels sticky on the ground. Whereas if you're at lower speeds, you're not feeling as planted on the ground, especially with a car like this, especially since the way that I drive it, which is, let's go through the options. Automatic transmission, zero traction control because I'm a madman. Perhaps I should add a little bit because it makes it a little bit difficult to drive, but I just love driving without traction control. I turn off the ASM, stability control, ABS, I left that alone, driving assistant, took that off. The car settings, well, they've been reduced because you got this balance of performance thing per track. I don't quite understand that, but I will do soon. So things can be changed to fit in with the balance of performance per track. Right, so let's get into this. My preference is the in-car view, as you can see. So I'm just starting to get back into it. But like I said, it feels very realistic. The sounds are actually amazing. And as you can see, I stopped it already. Right, let's see if I can get this together. Let me turn up the sound so you can hear the audio. It sounds quite powerful. Feels very realistic. This is quite a powerful car. It does sit on race tires, hard racing tires. At low speeds, all that car going through the rear wheels is quite simple. And it oversteers quite easily at low speeds. Whereas at high speeds, like I said, dynamics kick in. Aerodynamics is. And as you can see, I spun it again. Thank you. probably going to get screwed in the comments, but it's all good. I mean, this is one of those games you kind of just have to relearn and kind of like study the dynamics and physics of each card. And as you kind of come to grips with it by making many mistakes like I am, where you learn how to kind of utilize the characteristics on the card to make the most of it. Control, stability control. I mean, I like it raw, giggity. I like it, you know, like with full control of the car. You know, obviously, you see that I don't have that full control of the car, but that will come. Giggity, that will come. You know, give me a couple of weeks, I'm drifting this car. Probably not on this track. Well, no, no, no. To me, it feels very, very realistic. Like I said, though, I understand pretty much feels on the plane. Well, some of these cars are going to be ridiculously fast in two, so I'm not going to get any front end grip, or very limited front end grip. And like I said, at the high speeds, the dynamics kick in. Markers, it kind of gives you a guide, a visual guide of where you should be, the racing line. In fact, racing line just about travels. It's a very helpful guide for beginners, you know, trying to learn the track, trying to learn kind of like the positions that you should be in, the lines that you should be taking. to like the rumble, the vibration through the controller. It feels very tight, you know, it feels very, you know, the way shaking bumps they see on screen. It's very much on point with kind of what I feel through the joke. Vibration function of this game, of the previous game, and enhanced it. That it could be due to the better spec vibration motors in the PlayStation 4's controller. Definitely no 9 minute kind of nerve over kind of that. But yeah. We do like little details such as like the men holding the green flags to say yes, the camp is clear. Compared to kind of like the same, very same track on Gran Turismo 6, it definitely feels more fluid. I do believe that the PlayStation 3 is running more like 720p-ish at times. There we go. It's the speed. Marathon, like I said, every day, you know, you have a daily workout task. 26 miles, the length of a marathon, done 13 miles, and I'll do another lap of this, and then I'll show you what car I get. The car of the day! Be back in the set, people. Yeah, I'm back, guys. So, yeah, this is the car, this is the gift card I did, so that I received after doing the driving marathon for today. It's a Lotus Evora 2009, fantastic little car. Let's see if we can have details to by it, but anyway, let's just jump straight into driving this joint. So we've got to sport. I would love to drive that Porsche. So quick qualifying. With the low times in this game, they're not that bad, but I wish it was a little bit faster, but then again, you know, you're loading the whole track and the dynamics of the car just take up. I mean, there's a lot of information to process, so it is what it is. As you can see, the car looks fantastic, it's very accurate, very realistic. So for the driving settings, chassis control off, let's go straight into it. Willow Springs.
Fantastic.
Yeah.